वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून. सो टुडे वी विल सी ए पाइपलाइन मल्टीप्लायर विथ CSA ट्री. ओके, एज द नेम सजेस्ट पाइपलाइन मल्टीप्लायर. दिस इज यूज्ड इन योर पैरेलल कंप्यूटर्स एंड ए पाइपलाइन अप्रोच इज शोन. दैट मीन्स हियर वी आर टेकिंग द टू नंबर्स 46 एंड 23. विल सी हाउ दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन इज परफॉर्म्ड. And then thereafter subsequent numbers may be inputted and output may be obtained. Okay, so this is a pipeline multiplier. This is called latch. This is latch. Latch is a fast register, very fast register, which temporarily holds the intermediate results. Latch is between the two stages. This is stage one. This is stage 2, this is stage 3, this is stage 4, and this is stage 5. And between the two stages there is a latch. Just like between two bogies of a train there is a coupling. A person directly does not go from one coach to another coach. He goes through the coupling. Similarly here also, data does not go from stage 1 to stage 2 directly, rather it goes through a latch. Latch temporarily holds the data. So this is the concept of pipeline. Any pipeline, pipelines are used in a number of places. So here in this case, these are the latches, these are the stages. Here A and B are inputted, shifted multiplicand generator. This is called shifted multiplicand generator. Then CSA means carry save adder. CSA means carry save adder, and CPA means carry propagation adder. CSA takes three inputs and gives two outputs. Carry save adder takes three inputs and gives two outputs, and outputs are carry and sum. Carry and sum. But output of CPA is only sum. Okay. So in this way ultimately we will get the product of two numbers, and I will show how this computation is performed. Okay. So A and B are inputted, it goes to shifted multiplicand generator, and then different, these are weights W1, 2, 3, we will see that CSA1, CSA2. Then CSA3, CSA4, CPA, and ultimately lastly the result. We will show how this computation is performed in this, through this architecture. So suppose we want to multiply the two numbers 46 and 23. So in normal multiplication we know this is the normal multiplication of 46 into 23. Suppose we convert into binary. Suppose we convert 46 into binary. It will be something like this. That means 10, 10, 10, this is equivalent to 46 in binary. Similarly for 23 it will be like this. That means 10, 10, 10, this is binary form of 23. And suppose we multiply in binary form these two numbers like this, 10, 10, 10 into 10, 11, then product will be something like this, 10, 10, 10, 10, 0, then 1 0, triple 1 0, then 0 0 0 0 0 0, and again 1 0, triple 1 0, like this. And suppose you add, then it will become 0 1 0. That means 0, zero, 1 0 and 1 0, zero, 1 0. Here it is 0, right. This is the final answer, which is equal to 1058. You can test it also. Suppose we convert this into binary form. See, this is the final answer. 1 4 times 0, 1 triple 0, and 1 0. So we have tested this product, which we have obtained through multiplication, is same as which is obtained by converting 1058. Okay. This is clear. That means we are multiplying 46 into 23 in decimal form, binary form also we have shown, and we have converted this result into binary, and it is same thing. Okay. So this is the final answer we know. Let us see whether it is coming or not through this pipeline multiplier. So one thing more. For pipeline multiplier, what trick is there, what technique is there? That is, this is the normal procedure of multiplication. So mind it, what we are doing, this is weighted number. This is, you are seeing, this is shifted, means there is hidden weight, and that is like this. We have added 0, and since I have told CSA takes 3 inputs, there are 2 CSAs, that means 6 inputs should be there. So I am writing one more dummy number here, which will not change the number, final answer, like this. this is not going to change the number, only 0 is added, but we will call this as W1, W2, W3, W4, W5 and W6. This is the technique, this is the, that means concept. So, in this way you can see that previous one, that means this figure. CSA1 is taking input of W1, 2, 3 and CSA2 is taking input of W4, 5 and 6. That means W1, 2, 3, this is going to CSA1, 4, 5, 6 is going to CSA2. Now, in the next board, we have to add like this W1, 2, 3. So, let us see for CSA1. So, you can see it that W1, 2, 3 are like this. 3. That means CSA1, it is this is W1 and this is W2 and this is W3, okay, you can check it, W1, W2, W3 that I have written here, because board is changing, that is why I am taking the help of this page here. So, this will give carry, sum and carry like this. If you add this 0, carry is 0, 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 1, carry is 0, 1 carries 0, 1 carries 0, 2 carries 0, 1 carries 0, carries 0. So, this is called carry and this is called sum. This is the output of CSA1. Now, CSA2. You can see W4, 5 and 6 are the inputs of CSA2, that means it is something like this. This is W4, this is W5, this is W6, okay. You can check it. This is W4, this is W5, this is W6, 4, 5 and 6. If you add this like this, it will become 0, that means this is sum, this is carry. This is output of CSA2. Pardon?
Carry.
Carry.
Yes, sir.
Yes. 2. Okay. 0 and this one should be right. Right. Okay. Right. Very good. You have pointed. 0, 0. it is correct now. And CSA 3, what is the, let us see, CSA 3, that means sum of CSA 1 and carry and sum of CSA 2, sum of CSA 1 and carry and sum of CSA 2. So, sum of CSA 1, that means this one, sum of CSA 1, that means 0, 1, 0, 111, 1. This is sum of CSA 1. Sum of CSA 1. And what is other? Sum and carry of CSA 2. As from the figure you can see, sum and carry of CSA 2 are going in CSA 3. Okay. So, sum and carry of CSA 2. So, note how I am writing here, 2 times 0. Like this, 4 times 1 and 2 times 0. Okay. And sum will be written like this, 0, 1, 0, 1, double 0, double 1. Okay, this one is carry of CSA 2, this is carry of CSA 2 and this one is sum of CSA 2. Let us apply, then this will become 0, 0, 1, 0. This should be 0. One. Okay, this is correct. 0, 1, 0, carry is 0, 1, carry is 0, 0, carry is 0, 1, 1, 0, carry is 1, 1, carry is 0, 1, 1, 0, carry is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, carry is 1, 1, 1, 0, carry is 1, 0, 0, 0, carry is 0, 1, carry is 0, 0, carry is 0. Like this. So, this is about CSA 3. Then let us see for CSA 4. CSA 4, see the figure. CSA 4 is taking input as carry of CSA 1, carry of CSA 1 and carry and sum of CSA 3. Note it carefully. Output of CSA3 as carry sum and carry of CSA1. That you have to input like this. That means carry of CSA1, carry of CSA1, this one. This is carry of CSA1. And carry and sum of CSA3, which is like this. Right. So, if you add, this will become 0, carry is 0, 1, carry is 0, 0, carry is 0, 0, carry is 0, 1, 1, 0, carry is 1, 0, carry is 0, 0, carry is 1, 0, carry is 0. Triple 0 1 0 1, actually लिखने में गलती हुई है. Right, here one mistake is there. It is like this. So, so 0 carry is 0, 1 1 0 carry is 1, 1 carry is 0, 1 carry is 0, 1 carry is 0, 0 carry is 0, and 0 carry is 0. Let us see. Okay, so this is carry, this is sum, this is the output of CSA. Now you can see the figure. Output of CSA4 is going into CPA, CPA receives carry and sum of CSA4 and simply adds and gives output, simply adds. That means what will be the input of CPA? Space is not here, I am writing in next board. Okay, this is carry and this is sum of CSA4 and we have to add. So CPA will be something like this. CPA will receive carry and sum of CSA4 That means this is carry of CSA4 and this is sum of CSA4 and if you simply add 0 1 0 0 0 1 0, so this is the final answer and you can see this was the final answer, that means equal to 1058 which we had started in very beginning. 1 4 times 0 1 000 10 let us see. 1 4 times 0 1 3 times 0 10 1058. So in this way, with this hardware architecture, you can say this is hardware algorithm. This type of hardware architecture is used for multiplication of two numbers, okay, with CSA carry save adder and carry propagation adder like this. A pipeline multiplier with CSA tree in which two numbers are shown here, how they are getting multiplied with this type of architecture. This much complicated architecture is there for multiplication of two numbers, okay. Any doubt you can ask.
One question.
Yes.
We can add 6-bit number, but to more than 6-bit number, what?
Yes, yes, very good question. Sit down. Suppose this is 6-bit number, okay, very good question. But suppose number is long, maybe 9-bit, 10-bit, anything, then you will have to add another CSA here, that means a parallel architecture, and number of stages will also increase. As long as you do not receive this CPA, CPA will receive only two inputs. So parallelly one more architecture will be drawn, then what will become? It will start receiving 12, W1 to W12. That means first 6-bit number, second, and similarly 6, that means it will be, that means 3, 3, 3 and 3. In this way we can go on increasing if we have to multiply larger number. Okay, any other question? Any other question from the audience?
Yes, sir.
Ha.
Sir, my name is Joseph Mishra. My question is, what is the role of pipeline?
Yes, sit down. Pipeline, that means here you are showing, that means seeing that we have taken the example for 46 into 23 only. Suppose after that 12 into 13 is to be done, is to be multiplied, then when these two numbers reach here, that means from here shifted multiplicand to CSA1, then this stage is vacant and it is ready to receive another two numbers. When these two numbers are reaching here in third stage, then that means this content of this is reaching here, it will receive another two numbers. This is the concept of pipeline anywhere, whether it is addition, multiplication, anything. That means as the process goes on, new process starts in first stage. In this way pipeline continues, so it will go on adding at go on multiplying and multiplying a large set of numbers, okay. Any other question? Yes, you may ask any type of question. Yes, huh?
Yes, sir. I want to ask one question, that where we use pipeline multiplier.
Yes, very good question. Pipeline multiplier is used in all parallel computers, which are called supercomputers nowadays. Supercomputer is a trade name, actual technical name is parallel computer. So everywhere this multiplier shifted multiplication is done in this manner only. which generally people don't know. This type of hardware architecture is present everywhere in all computers, in all parallel computers. This is the type of that means architecture in all parallel computers, supercomputers. This in this manner this multiplication is done. And you want to know what are the parallel computers, then as I had told earlier also, top 500 ORG, this is the website, you can see what are the top 500 supercomputers, top 500 supercomputers of world. And this list is released in every 6 months, okay. Top 500 ORG, this that means list is updated in every 6 months. And what are the top 500 supercomputers of world, their configuration, that is given. So these are the parallel computer supercomputers, okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes, yes, another question.
We cannot use pipeline, so architecture is different or same?
See, without, if you don't want to sit down, don't want to use pipeline, then also you will have to make use of this type of architecture, because in other way it is not possible. In some manner, because I have shown this algorithm in detail, how this multiplication is done. Only addition is the fundamental type of operation. Other things you have to apply, that means you have to make certain algorithm. For multiplication also we have to use certain algorithm. So for that purpose you have to, that means make a separate architecture, and this is the type of architecture. So automatically this is a pipeline architecture. There is no need of multiplying only two numbers and forget like that. So this may receive a series of numbers. It is up to you. If you want to apply for two numbers only and then no number is there, doesn't matter. Facility is there, okay.
Sir.
Yes.
My name is Anshu. और मेरा क्वेश्चन ये है कि जो हम शिफ्टेड मल्टीप्लायर जो जनरेटर है उसका यूज़ करते हैं, तो उसमें हम डब्ल्यू सिक्स तक ही यूज़ करते हैं, तो हम उससे ज़्यादा क्यों यूज़ नहीं कर सकते और डब्ल्यू सिक्स तक ही हम लोग क्यों यूज़ करते हैं?
सो आई हैव गिवन दिस आंसर, वी कैन यूज़ अप टू 12 ऑल्सो. सिमिलरली वन मोर शिफ्टेड मल्टीप्लिकेंट जनरेटर वी कैन अप्लाई एंड सी एस ए 1, 2, 3, 4. We can use more also. Here it is shown W6 because CSA can receive only 3 inputs and 2 CSAs are there, therefore 6 inputs are shown. Then this will go on, that means it will become very long type of figure, because ultimately it has to reduce in 2 only, because CPU receives only 2 inputs and then it will give the final answer. So it may be W12 and even more also, okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.